How to create a backup image using EaseUS Todo free. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I talk about backing up a lot, and honestly, one of the very first questions I get whenever I say, hey, before you do this, take an image backup. Before you do that, take an image backup. Great, how do I take an image backup? There are several different ways, several different tools. What I'm going to do in this video is walk you through downloading and installing the free version of EaseUS Todo, and then using that to create an image backup of my machine. Let's get started. So we're here in Windows 11. I'm going to go ahead and fire up Edge. I head on over to Google and search for EaseUS Todo free. It is important to realize that EaseUS will try to push you onto their paid-for product. Follow the steps here carefully so that you don't accidentally end up with the free trial, which is not what we want. We're actually using the truly free version. So we'll click on free download. And here you can see free versus home. I don't care. All we really want to do is create an image. We'll download that. I'm going to go ahead and open it. At this point, I can close the browser. I'm done with that. And we'll hit custom install, because I always recommend using custom install, even if there's no reason. You always want to use custom install in case somebody tries to slide something in on you. English location is fine. We'll hit install now. Downloading the tool, installing the tool, and in a moment we'll be good to go. Okay, the installation is done. We'll go ahead and hit start now. You'll notice, by the way, that they did throw an icon on the desktop. If for some reason this doesn't appear or you're coming back later, of course, that's the icon to double click to start the program. But we'll just hit start now here. Now, like I said, they are pushing their paid product. I understand that, but we don't need that. So once again, I'm going to close the browser that they started up for me. I'm going to close their upgrade offer. And here we are. Welcome to EaseUS Todo Backup. What we are going to do is create a backup. We're creating a backup of a disk. We're going to back up the entire C drive. We're taking an image of all of the partitions on our C drive. That will include Windows, of course, but it'll also include the UEFI partition, any recovery partitions, any other stuff that's on that physical hard drive. So I'll click on disk. Now you'll notice I have two disks on this system. I have this hard disk 1 and this hard disk 0. Pay attention to which one it is has the C drive on it. In my case, that's this one. I'm going to click the checkbox for it. This way, the FAT32 partition, which I believe is the UEFI partition, and a couple of other partitions, like I mentioned, quite possibly the recovery partition for Windows, in addition to the C drive itself, will all be backed up. I'm leaving the other drive unchecked because that's where I'm going to place my backup. Now, you can see that it has already pre-selected a place. I'm going to go ahead and click this so we walk through the process of actually selecting a destination. Click on local drive. If I had an external drive for this specific machine, this is where I would select it. In my case, I have the second internal drive. EaseUS recommends they use a My Backups subfolder on there. That's fine. But this is how and where you would select whatever drive letter or whatever folder represents your external drive to receive the backup image. Remember, it cannot be the C drive. It must be a different drive on your machine. We'll click on OK. At this point, we just click on Backup Now. That's it. It really is that simple. You can see now that EaseUS Todo is going through the animations associated with backing up my disk, my C drive, and all the partitions on it, to /my backups. Now, we're going to let that run for a little while, and we'll come back and take a look at what the result looks like. And we're done. That's it. We've created an image backup. We don't need to worry about these other options. Those are for more advanced situations when you're using EaseUS, maybe on a regular basis or on an automated basis, or if you've actually paid for the home version. All we're going to do now is take a look at what the result is. I'm going to go ahead and close EaseUS Todo, fire up Windows File Explorer, go out to my second internal drive and take a look at my backups. Disk 0, that's the disk we backed up. And here it is, disk 0, 2025-02-10, which is the current date, full, which is the kind of backup we did, V1, presumably you can have multiple versions, .pdb, which is the EaseUS Todo backup image format. That's a backup image. We have successfully created a backup image of the C drive. If this were an external drive, we could disconnect it, throw it in a drawer, and just get to it when we needed it. Now, the most common question that happens once we're done creating an image backup is, well, what if I need it? What do I do with it? There are a number of articles on askleo, and there are a number of videos associated with those articles that walk you through restoring the image, creating the rescue media, restoring individual files from the image, which I think is something that a lot of people don't realize is honestly one of the more valuable scenarios that you can run into. But what's most important here is that we have created the backup image. No matter what happens to our machine, whatever happens to this machine, doesn't matter, because we can now restore it, should we need to exactly what it was at the time we just took this backup. So one of the reasons I so strongly suggest taking an image backup like this before anything major, like a Windows update or a big install or any number of scenarios that have you worried that the machine might not be everything it's supposed to be when that is done. Easy. Take an image backup first, and you've just seen now how quick and easy that can be. For updates, for comments, for some of those links I talked about and more, visit askleo.com/178321. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.